At its F8 conference in San Francisco, Facebook announced the first hardware it plans to use to beam the internet down to billions of people around the world. Codenamed as Aquila, the solar-powered drone has a wingspan comparable to a Boeing 737, but it weighs less than a small car. It will be powered by solar panels on its wings, and it will be able to stay at altitudes of more than 60,000 feet for months at a time. Facebook says it will begin test flights this summer, with a broader rollout over the next several years.
The second part of planetary connectivity is making sure that everyone can participate in the internet. This is the problem that all of us in this room probably take for granted. You're all here on 4G or possibly Wi-Fi, and it probably wouldn't surprise you that 4G distribution across the world isn't that broad. There's many places in the world that don't have access to 4G. You say, well, what about 3G? Yep, more people have 3G access. And even if you go back to Edge or 2G, which most of you probably haven't used for a decade, it still doesn't cover the entire planet. We'd estimate 1 to 3 billion people do not currently have access to internet data. And when you tease apart this problem and try to understand why is it that people can't get internet access, it's actually a basic lesson in economics and geography. In urban, dense urban areas, it is economically feasible to recoup the massive capital investments telcos have to do to provide internet access. You're doing terrestrial infrastructure, where you're literally digging ditches and laying fiber, or stringing fiber across poles. They're putting up cell phone towers. You're doing lots of work on the ground to provide this access. And this costs billions of dollars that you need to recoup over a large subscriber base. As you move to more rural areas of the world, you just can't recoup those costs. So what we're doing with Connectivity Labs is investing, as we have in OCP and others, in radical new approaches to this problem. And this basically means going to the sky. You have to have satellites, drones, and other things that don't require the massive investments in terrestrial infrastructure in order to affordably provide internet access for this world. This is a picture of Aquila, our first prototype for our unmanned aerial vehicle. This is a solar-powered drone built by a team who has the record for the longest ever solar-powered drone flight. The idea of this is to loiter across an area at very high altitude, 60 to 90,000 feet in the air, stand on station for months at a time, and beam down backbone internet access. From this photo, it's hard to get a sense of scale, and this is an early prototype for testing out the aerodynamics. To give you a sense of the scale of this thing, this is us actually constructing the full-scale version. This is several wing segments, so this is actually one of the wing segments. And if we were to show this thing in real life, it is the wingspan greater than a 737 plane. All of you are probably familiar with that. And it has the mass of a small car. So it's a massive wing structure with solar panels so that it can stay aloft for long periods of time. This is one of many initiatives that we're doing that we'll be able to talk in a lot more detail about later this year to provide internet connectivity for the whole world. So that's phase one. We need to get the whole world on the internet and provide all of you to build the technology needed to build services to scale.